Hi everyone, I'm Carl, and in this video I'm going to 3D scan this 28mm miniature into a 3D model in 5.5 easy steps. I'm going to use a technique called photogrammetry, where you can take a bunch of reference pictures, run them through your software, and get a 3D model out the other end. Now, I used to think that 3D scanning was something that had to be done in a lab or using some very expensive equipment. But thanks to Steve from CG Geek, I learned that it can be done with some awesome free software and equipment we already have. In his tutorial, Steve demonstrates how you can capture a large object, and I highly recommend watching it, because he explains the process really well. What I'll be doing in this video is capturing a small object using a slightly different technique, which should be easier for this size. So let's get started. First, choose your subject. Miniatures are almost a worst case scenario for this kind of work, because they're very small and the detail is tiny. We're talking fractions of a millimeter here. Add that to the fact that I'm going to be running a painted miniature through this process, and it makes it even worse. The first miniature I tried to scan was this one I sculpted about 20 years ago. Unfortunately, it has very little detail for the software to latch onto, and it includes parts that are covered in metallic paint plus a layer of varnish, which totally confused the software. The results were, let's say, trippy. Instead, now I'm going to try with this Games Workshop zombie, purely for experiment. People, don't copy copyrighted stuff, it's not cool. This model has more clearly defined detail and color variations, which should help. Step 2, lighting. To begin with, I taped down my light box to a solid surface so it wouldn't move as I worked. The light box ensures that the lighting is consistent and that the object is properly illuminated. I'm not using a background in the light box here, since the depth of field seems to help the process. Also, well, the results with a background were kind of funky. Third, photograph the mini at consistent angle intervals. From experiments I did yesterday, I determined that my hands are not good at this level of precision. Instead, I made a small jig, which I can use to turn the miniature 10 degrees each time. This is literally just two paper circles with angle markings and held together with a pin. Since the pin stuck some way out of the surface, I also did a bottle cap so that the mini would sit flat, and then taped the mini on top. With the subject in place, I set up the camera on a tripod and made sure that all the settings were set to manual. This ensures that all the settings remain the same through the shooting, and I'm using my video camera to take stills here. Though we should be able to get better results from a photo camera, since the sensor tends to be larger. Step 4, I started stamping photos. After every photo, I rotated the subject 10 degrees, and then I repeated this a couple of times from different heights. Step 5, I took my SD card and imported all the photos into Meshroom. The software is free to download and use, and you can find the link in the description below. It's a magnificent tool, and honestly, I have to tell the team who made this, you blew my mind. I mean, look at that, you just need to hit start and off it goes. At this point, I just had to let it work. Okay, it's a little bit later, and we can see that it has arranged the photos and plotted the rough location of each in relation to the model. It looks promising, but I'm also noticing that it only used 95 out of the 111 source images. Usually it means that there wasn't enough data in that photo to plot points from one photo to the next. You can see how the ring is broken at the points where these photos would have been. Okay, more time went by and it's done. I'm going to load the model and hide the density points, and yeah, it mostly looks great. But we're missing some parts like the jaw and the fingers on the left hand. And this corresponds to the missing images. I gotta say, I'm still very impressed with the quality of what did get modeled, so I'm going to see if I can get it to process those images for a complete model. Okay, this is where things kind of got a bit funny. So, to get a better quality scan, first thing I tried to do was set the definer preset to high, which worked for a bit, but then it stopped working because it ran into a known issue, a known bug in version 2019.1. So, no big deal. What I did was I went back and downloaded version 2018.1 and set it running again, and that seemed to work fine with the high preset. I don't think that's a big deal for me, and to be honest, if I had used a better camera in the first place, I don't think I would have needed the high preset anyway. I'm also told that the next version with the fix for this will be out in the coming months. So yeah, to be honest though, if you're going to try this, what I would suggest is get 2019 anyway, and chances are if you're using a decent camera, you're not going to have this problem anyway. I'm just telling you this so that you know why the interface looks slightly different in the next part of the video. The reason I'm finding it funny is kind of... I've been testing this for a few days now with different data sets, different presets, different photos, and yeah, the only time it decided to give up on me and fail in any way was when I was filming, so... Okay, and after that brief interlude, we're back in Meshroom. That's step 5.5 if we're keeping track, and I do believe we have a hit. The model looks complete this time, and this is great. There are a couple of artifacts around the armpits and near the crotch, but boy, this is great scale for a miniature. And it's stuff I can clean up in Blender anyway. This is really neat. Okay, I'm going to open it up in Blender to take a closer look. Nice thing about this is that if the cycles renderer is selected, the material nodes are applied automatically. We just need to reposition and rescale the model and check out all the detail. Considering this is a photo scan of a 28mm mini with an OK camera, what the software did was pretty amazing. Oops, meant to go for the material display there. Render isn't going to show much since the lights aren't set right anyway. And that's it for this experiment. Of course, I barely scratched the surface here, and there's a lot I need to learn about preparing images, tweaking settings. However, I'm now confident that this is doable. I hope you found this useful, and if you did, I'd really appreciate if you hit the like button below. If you have any comments or suggestions, I'd love to hear them, so do leave a comment. And before I close this off, I'd just like to thank the people who made Meshroom. They really made a fantastic product. Maximum respect. And thanks also go to CGKeek for the smashing tutorial. Thank you for watching and see you around.